Welcome back, guys. This is Zombie Waffles. This is episode 4 because of a pretty big blunder on my part. I did record the entire making of this wheat farm. but while saving the full edited video, I deleted the raw video that I did not think it needed anymore, but it ended up needing it. And so when I came back to check on my video, it had erred and there was no real way to fix it. So this is the wheat farm that I spent the entire real fourth episode making. It took a long time. I had to get a lot of resources, which I will show you in a moment. So we're just going to make this video the new fourth episode. It is 4 rows of 16 wheat. I'm not sure how much reed this is, but this is the way I do my own personal lighting systems for the floors of my house and pathways and stuff. So it's just 2 down and a torch and then some glass on top of it and an alternating pattern. Sometimes I use a different block instead of these wood planks, but yeah, that's our reed farm. For this episode, we're gonna work on what will be our house, which is this awesome little cavern that was just kinda here when we spawned. So I'll go ahead and show you guys all the resources that I did gather to, I made a lot of torches, a lot of polished stone, there was quite a bit more, and a lot of cobblestone in there that I used. I've been making a massive, birch forest here that I've just kind of been growing and cutting down while waiting for stuff to smelt. I did have to steal a lot of leaves for the rim around this. I still have a lot in my inventory. A lot of dirt I pulled up while digging out the extra space for this. This is a lot bigger than what it actually was if you go back and look. And also, in order to do that floor, I did dig this whole space, this whole kind of rectangle here. I did dig down about 3 more so that I could do kind of a foundation for those torches. A lot of glass. I went to the desert again and collected quite a bit of new stuff. And that's about all that I got. I had to go get some more lapis lazuli, so I did drop down into the mines. Had to get some more cobblestone, so I went down there. So I got some lapis lazuli. I used blue glass to make torches in the middle of my waterway. Let's go down back to the wheat farm here real quick. So you can't really see it from here, but when you come up, this block here is actually a piece of dyed blue glass and a torch underneath so that my crops will grow healthy at the night times. But yeah, so I want to turn this all into a nice little room. I'm going to go ahead and put some stuff away in my chest real quick. Clear out some space, see what we need and what we don't need. Start with our trees, put our leaves in here. We do have quite a bit of extra reed. I have just been harvesting the reed. I still haven't harvested any of the wheat from, or carrots from, the first time that I planted those. So we'll just toss our reed in here. Gunpowder. That birch forest has been spawning a mighty amount of hostile mobs. It gets a little overwhelming at times. I really wish that I had the clip from that. There was one point while I was building the glass ceiling of that awesome little place that I had to come over here and get some glass, and all I saw was a creeper run out from the wooded area there with all intent to do me harm. And I just kind of tossed all my glass and ran, and ended up that there was another creeper just to my left coming after me that, if I hadn't backed up at that exact moment, would have gotten me as well. So, glad I just kind of took off on that one. So, just gonna kind of fill in some of this area here. Let's grab some torches. Just because this is kind of a little cavern. Make sure we have enough light. You guys can see as well. It's just really nice having a whole bunch of torches there. Did have to chop down a lot of trees. Is it going nighttime? Yeah, okay. That's why it's getting dark as well. So it is getting darker. Gonna light this up a little bit, but I will still go sleep real quick. Let's just fill this in. Voila. And I'm gonna go sleep and we'll catch back up. Alright guys, so I went ahead and grabbed a bit more polished stone, and it is morning now. So, I'm gonna want a second room kinda back here on the right side of these stairs, but, you know, a little further back, you know, tucked away, so that I have a nice little secure area. But, I also want to make sure I have a room that lines up with something that we can put in our mine over here. Wow. See, this forest is just so compact. Can't even navigate through it. Alright, but we pulled it off. So we're gonna run over here to our mine real quick. And I want to have the preset for a tunnel. So, go ahead and do a little bit of just like a hallway back here. Gonna make it 3 wide. Oh, okay, I have another one. Let's go ahead and just keep on mining. And so, I don't want it on this level because I'm probably gonna have a lot of chests up here and other assorted items. Who knows, maybe an enchantment table, just to kind of have it handy dandy nearby. So I want to carve this 6 back, so we're going to go, nope, wait, do I want it 6, let's see, 3, no, I want it to be 8, so we're going to go 8 down, we're at 5, so 3 more. Okay, so, yep, that's 8. So the reason I did this is I'll have a set of stairs going down right here. Now let's go down right here, and then later after I get done with the house, I'll come over here and I'll have a set of stairs going up, and you guys will see what that will be for when we get around to it. So let's just go ahead and start digging down. So we'll have steps at this block. Down one more. So we're gonna go down so that, what level are we at compared to like the water and stuff over here? So we are 1 block higher than the water level already. So what I'm gonna go ahead and do, I'll make it pretty deep. And so, from here we'd have, if I do the floor just like my wheat farm, from here we would have our glass layer, one more layer for torches, so glass, our torches, and then this would be the floor of our, kind of our foundation, our torch foundation. So I want that. This last layer to be the ceiling for this room down here. So we're gonna have to cut down at least 3 or 4. 4 more layers, so let's hurry up and just get that done with. So we'll go ahead and count 1, 2, 3. That's our foundation floor. 1, 2, 3 of walking space. So this is where we'll go ahead and have our next room's level set up. And so I guess I really should have gotten the cords from the first house. I didn't really think that our stairs would really pull us this far sideways. So we'll figure out how big of a room we really need to make off of here. Looks like it's... I can't have a 4 high ceiling though. I'm gonna have to fill all this in real quick. Don't know how nuts that will drive me later. That should be fine. Okay. So, go ahead, fill that in. So we'd have stairs right here, so we want another 3 for our walkway that direction. Hurry up, this out real quick. And then we'll run back to our actual house and check on some quartz to try and line up with here. Piggy. And the reason that this side of the wheat farm isn't kind of rounded off like that side is because I do plan on eventually having one that looks exactly like this for both the carrots and potatoes, if we do find potatoes, and I'll just kind of extend them that way. So I didn't want to have to destroy all that glass, so I just kind of made like a segmented version. I did seriously just kind of screw up that whole episode. That sucked. Was not too happy about that. So trying to decide if we're gonna have some flush walls here or not. I want to have it kind of opened up for this entryway right here, so we will have stairs starting right here. So I'll go ahead and fill at least this area in. Hop over, booyah. Okay, so I want to fill in this area here. Kind of get that looking a little better. Right in here. Aw. Have to screw up something every now and then. Toss that block in. So that'll start right there. Kind of like this side. This side should be one higher. Just like that. Same thing to this side. So that one's almost perfectly set up already. Actually, it is. So I'm not gonna worry about replacing all of the dirt right now. I'm just kind of getting a layout for everything. So since this is our home, we're gonna try and make it a little less compact than like our mine stairs. That's why I'm doing these ones 5 wide. Plus I really do have an idea for what I'm gonna do to kinda roof this all off. So it's just gonna look better with 5 wide. So I guess I'll go ahead and repeat the same thing for a set of stairs going down here. So we'll go ahead and make this 5 wide. And for now we'll cut only about 4 high. I may actually end up cutting it all the way up though, so that I can do the same roof pattern as this next one. And it is getting kind of close to nighttime here, so I'll throw up another torch up there. And I'll go ahead and Dang. Dang, 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 guys. Okay. I need to get this quartz thing down a little bit better, so I'm gonna go ahead and sleep here real quick. And what I'm actually gonna do is I'm gonna have to run all the way back over to the mine, and we're gonna check to see what Y level we are at over there, so that I can just have a nice, flat track to take me from my mine to my house. So one or the other may have to be adjusted differently. If it really comes down to it, I will probably just adjust the height in the mine because I don't care so much about the mine. All it really does is, so we're at 58. All it really does is, give me my materials. I don't have to spend a whole lot of time looking at the aesthetics of it. But since like the wheat farm's kind of gonna be connected to my house, I wanted that to look really nice. And so we'll do a lot of the same thing to the inside of our nice little cavern villa right over here. So we are at 58 over there. Where are we at? Standing right here. So we're at 61. So 58's only 3 lower than this. That could actually work out. You know what? I can picture it now. I'll show you what I will do. So we will just go ahead and carve only like 3 down right here. And once we have the stairs cut down here to 58, that's where we should be. Yep. So we're gonna go ahead and cut just kind of like just a little tunnel area, a little bit bigger than a normal tunnel area. Something that we can fit our mine cart and probably a launcher into. So that I can haul sail just kind of all the way over here. So we'll do it 5 wide, maybe 7 right here. If I decide to throw in some chests at some point, let's throw down a torch. So our stairs, we'd have 3. Let's go 2 more. Okay. So we will have stairs right here, and right here. Dang, I really actually might want to just open that up more. It really does. It's a little irritating, isn't it? So we'll have probably a mine track right here. Now we'll just shoot this way. And I mean, this whole thing will probably be a whole different project of its own. I won't really go too far. But we will check to see what chord this lines up at. So the one that's staying constant here besides 58 is 251. So that's that chord that we need to match up with over in our mine base. So let's make sure we can hit that pretty easily, and we don't have to shift anything around. Oh, I can't jump right there. Left a little escape block right there for myself. Do 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 do. And then once we make sure that everything is nice and lined up, we won't have any sort of a problem just going over there and setting up our house, which is really the main point of this episode. But since our house is going to connect to our mine, kind of have to do a little bit of both at the same time here. So where are we at? Show this. So we're at 245, so I have to go about 6 that way. I think we're at 251 is where I called it, so only 6 that way. That's not bad at all. So that should line up just about perfect. So we'll just go ahead and leave everything for now. We'll come over here to the mine and set up the mine half later on. It was the gravel. I was gonna say, I was a little odd. It almost sounded like I was eating food as I ran out the door there. I definitely wasn't. I'm not hungry. Why am I not hungry? I'm not in peaceful, am I? Why am I in peaceful? Sorry, I switch between a lot of different maps. And play in peaceful on my creative mode. But so that's good. Like I said, this might actually just drive me completely bonkers. Just seems way too packed. Not enough room to just walk around. I'll just extend that one. Yeah, that's fine. Alright, we'll do a little better of a torch setup in here. So those are across from each other. Those are across from each other. So we'll just go ahead and leave that. Ooh. Something I did not think about. I plan on raising this floor. Yeah, so our floor will actually be at the same level as this grass right here. Now I'm hungry. Well, we'll be at the same level as this grass right here. So that's gonna have to come out a ways. And my stairs are gonna be screwed up. Man. I just didn't think this through. Not very well at all. So, what to do to problem solve? Problem solving time. Should I just leave my house two lower than the rest of this out here? Does that seem acceptable? Or should I just kind of deal with the stairs? Stairs be easier or harder? I want to leave the stairs where they're at. I really do. So I think I'll just go ahead and make this whole thing kind of two lower than our front yard will be. It'll be a nice little... It'll keep our house cool. It's hot around here. We're right next to the savannah. You know, blazing sun. In the evening. So I will have to cut this whole thing down to... that would have saved me a lot more time if I didn't have to, but I mean, you gotta do what you gotta do. So I think we're gonna start by filling in our ceiling here a bit. We'll just start off by where the most of all of this stuff is, which now I can't tell. Not too high. So do we want to do it from this level? How high are we? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Let's go ahead and do 6. So yeah, we'll fill it all in from here. Hopefully that won't take too much. Once again, I say hopefully. It probably will. So this is gonna be a really long, kinda crappy process to get all of this filled in. So I'll just go ahead and jump that, and we'll see you guys when my house has a nice ceiling to it, which is something I don't think I've seen yet. Alright guys, so we have our nice flush polished stone ceiling here now. I have no idea what this bat is doing. I think I kicked him out of his house. But so my next goal here is to try and figure out how I want to set up kind of like a little room over here. I think I need to see how far this cavern goes back first. Oh, so this actually kind of goes somewhere. Let's build a cheap little set of stairs here real quick. Guess I really probably should have a sword on me, but okay, so that doesn't really go anywhere. I'll collect this coal real quick. So not really anything that way. pieces iron, just a couple pieces. And is this dead end as well? Yes. Alright, so there's just two dead end little caverns, so probably won't really do anything with them. I already got all the materials that they have. There's at least a little bit of something. So break this torch, move it back there. So I will push this back a little bit. So at some point I will probably just kind of throw an enchantment table right down here. So that'll be 5x5. So we'll have another, what is this, 4 on the other side of that? 4. Okay. So we'll have a little 5x5, and I guess I'll just stick a little double bed right there. Nothing too fancy. But, you know. So this is already 5 back, so I guess we'll just go ahead, we'll fill in this wall right here. Gonna have to grab some more polished stone real quick. And now we'll start filling this in. And, I mean, this is all lit up back here, so I won't even worry about it. We'll just, from this day forward, act like that really doesn't exist back there. Till someday, I'm sure I'll drill into it and just kind of be, like, completely confused as to how I got in there and set torches in the first place. But we'll at least get a laugh out of that. And we'll fill all of this in real quick, and I'll change over all of this dirt. Alright, and so now that wall is nice and flush. At some point I will go through and this won't all just be polished stone. I just kind of like having a nice little layout for everything. So that I know what I have to work with. I'm sure I'll set some chests up over here, especially if we have an enchantment table right there. You know, I don't know if I'd be able to reach those or not, but we'll see. We'll just kind of toss some stuff together. And so now we're going to go ahead and do the same thing to this wall, except I will probably only leave this too high across, because we'll set up a little stair system to our front lawn here pretty soon, and I definitely want some windowage in this house. Can't just live in a cave. Alright, so, missed that little hole right there. So, it's getting nighttime, so I'll go take a nap real quick. We got that wall set up. I got a little bit from up there, and we got some series blocks glitching out here. I'll go ahead and tear that down a little later on, probably after I do the floor, everything a little bit more set up. So, what I'll end up doing for this floor, guys, is I'll just cut 2 down, make sure that then the new floor level is all nice polished stone, and then I will do the same kind of lighting pattern that I did for the walkway over there by my wheat farm, and I'll kick this video back up after I have that all completed. Alright, so we have finished up most of our floor. I went ahead and set all of the glass, the torches, and the stone. But unlike our wheat farm, I didn't really want to keep using aspen wood. So what I'm going to go ahead and do is make a lot of sandstone. And I'm going to go ahead and make the floor of my house some awesome sandstone. Just get this crafted up here real quick. Alright. And just these 2 stacks should be enough to get us through the whole floor. I don't think I needed more than that with the glass. So not too bad. I mean, I do this to most any of my major buildings or anything that I really want to have lit up well, where I don't want to have to worry about a mob getting into or anything like that. So, it is a little resource intensive, but whatever. I don't mind doing it. It keeps me happy. And normally, I mean, for this Let's Play, I'm doing normal mode, but I do normally play in hard, just to keep things real. Plus, after a little while, I really do kind of just overstock on food, and you exhaust your hunger faster in hard mode. So, I may switch it over at some point. I may not. Normal is fine for now, though. We have enough to finish this up. So, this is what the floor of our house is gonna look like. So, I'll have an enchantment table over here at some point. I'll get to work on setting up a cattle area at some point here soon, so that I can start getting all that leather, because now one of the hardest things to actually do in this game is get all of the leather for. It's not really that hard, but it's more labor intensive than it used to be to get all your chests and, or not your chests, your bookcases and stuff. So, hopefully I'll get to work on a cattle place at some point soon, but I'm really gonna need some wool at some point. I wanna make some more beds. But for now, I'm gonna kind of think about setting up some glass panes. I'll go ahead and take a nap here in a second. Stay down here and figure some more stuff out while I wait. Stick a piece of dirt here. So this can all be replaced real quick. I don't think I have a shovel on me. Break it by hand as fast as we can. God, just can't get that one piece, man. And place it, place, 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 place. Placing blocks. Left and right. Left and right. Oh, that's perfect. Okay, so gonna want a window for a lot of this. I may just do. I don't think I really want to do two windows. Seems almost a little obnoxious. Then again, I could make my entryway kind of center, so I'll go sleep real quick. We'll come back. We'll count how long this room is, and we'll see where we can set up kind of a little. Oh, there's a spider coming after me. I heard him. You hear him? You lose, spider. You lose. Can't touch this. Da-na-na-na. All right. Gonna make a sword so I can deal with this spider. Bring it. Bring it home, boy. Can't touch this. Where'd you go? Where is he? You're just gonna chill all the way over there? Bring it. Bring Got some string. Could always just try to make some wool out of string if I get enough. But, so each one of these glass blocks is gonna be two, so 2, 4, 6, 8, 10, 12, 14, 16, 18, 20. So we're 20 wide. So I'm gonna wanna have. I guess I'll set up an actual doorway for this house. I'll make the entryway too wide, and so minus two, so 2, 4, 6, 8. So right here, I'm gonna wanna dig these four out. And so from there, we'll set up some stairs right here. Gonna need to get some more polished stone here real quick. Alright, and we'll fill this in. Some more polished stone here as well. have. Let's do this all the way up on both sides. Oops. Just do that all the way up on both sides. And go like this. Oops. Not what I wanted to do there. Because we'll go ahead and we'll fill these little slivers up with glass panes. That'll make our little tiny entryway here kind of a little more appealing. And then... Oh, it's a little locked in place. So what I'll do is... I don't have any food on me. Oh, well, I guess I'll just starve for now. That's not going to be very appealing, though. I guess... Guess we won't. Maybe we won't. Let me think here, guys. This is a struggle. Every day I'm struggling. Struggling. So I guess I will just kind of fill that up. We'll say screw it. You do some fancy window panes on something else. Go ahead, do it like that. Same thing over here. Fill that in one more. Okay. It's gonna be right here. Let's fill this in, make this all nice and polished. Polished up. Some more. Might as well just grab a couple stacks this time. And I'll grab some food real quick. Okay, so we'll finish filling that in. And then same thing on this side. There, right there. These two, and then dig one layer down, and two. All nice. Okay. Pick up that. So I'll fill that in a second. You guys see what I'm doing. I'm gonna go ahead and do this over here. We'll fill that in and that. Do that as well. Turn these into dirt. Leave that though. Also go ahead and turn those around. Okay. So that's kind of the front of this so far. To extend this as well. I think we did it too wide. Yes, we did. Way to the wall. Okay. Fill this all in. And I want this same hole open on this side. So that was 4 high. Okay. And then I think I'll also go ahead and make the front windows of this. The lapis lazuli, the normal blue paint stained glass. So, hopefully that'll look pretty awesome. And then we'll see what I was gonna do with the rest of this. Let me grab some buckets and make my lapis lazuli glass, and I'll see you guys in a sec. Okay, so we have our paint stained glass here. Set this up. I'm not sure if I'll have enough or not. Hopefully I will. I think I started out with 48, so I think I'll actually have the perfect amount that I need. Which is just awesome. Totally did not plan that out. this work? Yes, it will. Alright, so we actually ended up with the perfect amount of those that we needed. So, now what I'll go ahead and do is I made some cobblestone slabs. And I'll set them all up around here. Oops, not what I wanted to do. That tall grass got in my way. Just like in Pokemon, never ride my tall grass. So I think I did cut that in one. Actually, no, that's flush with our wall. Okay. Alright, let me go grab a couple more things real quick. Gonna need to get my buckets from up here in the treehouse. Chest. Grab just a little bit of leaves. Come back outside. It's almost nighttime, so should time this out pretty perfectly. I didn't think about that with the glass. So I'll go ahead and I'll strip these out so that the glass isn't connecting. I'll just make that a stone layer instead and we'll have three high windows. So I'm gonna have little fountains here on each side of my entryway. Since I just kinda thought that'd be cool. Plus I figured it would go well with the blue stained glass. Let's run out here a little ways and see if we can get ourselves a look. So this is our nice little home now. I will probably do some clearing up here and level off this area up here off camera. Like I said, I'll also probably go ahead and fill in some stairs. And eventually we'll have a enchantment table right here. It'll go right here. It'll be just kind of sunk into the ground right where we need it. I'll probably put a double bed right here. We'll have chests in this wall right here. And I think we'll do furnaces over here. So we have just about everything we need. In one of these next episodes, I will set up my minecart after I have enough iron for that. Go ahead and destroy this dirt. And I think I'll call that an episode. Oh, forgot all of my leaves out here and get me blown up by a creeper doing this. Alright, so this is where everything looks like at night. Everything does stay lit up real well. As you can see, all of my reed has grown and my house is illuminating. So, gonna call that an episode. I hope you guys enjoyed. Hope you guys like our little pre-house setup here. Catch you guys next time.